And we're back with more roller derby action from Cleveland, Ohio. Good evening. I am Captain Lou Obama, joined by Mr. Whistler. You're watching 2015 International WFTDA Division II Playoffs live from Cleveland, Ohio, brought to you by Women's Flat Track Roller Derby, or Flat Track Derby Association even, and Burning River Roller Derby.
We are indeed, Captain
Lou.
Right now, we are going to see a St. Chux pack in black taking on the Jet City Bombers. St. Chux is from O'Fallon, Missouri, and right now are ranked at number 54 in the Women's Flat Track Derby Association. And Jet City hails from Everett, Washington, and they are currently ranked at number 57. These are the 7 and 8 seeds, respectively, in this tournament.
And let's get straight into the rosters for the St. Chux Derby Chicks Pack in Black. They are sending to the track number 103, Calamity Kate, 14, Psycho Kid to Freak Out, 18, Sugar Shock, 187, Zombie F-Bomb, 22, Terra Eyes, number 4, Jedi Nightingale, 417, Shaquilla, 47, Whiplash, 480, Pixie Destruction, that's the captain, number 5, Slaughterhouse, 50 is 50 Shades of Pink, 80, Connor, 831, Joni Ramone, 888 is Big Red, and wearing the A on the bench is Night Glider.
And a run-through of the Jets, Jet City roster, the Jet City Rollergirls Bombers. They will be wearing white for this game. Number 1, Sia Wouldn't Wanna Be A. Number 11, Start to Riot. Number 12, Nasty Nikki Nightstick. 13, Eva Derche. Number 15, Ill Ninja. Number 19, The Mexorcist. Number 3, Chick Let's Rock. Number 31 is Chantilly Cream. Number 39, Whoa Nelly. Number 41, Assaulted Peanut. Number 44, Sangria. Number 5, Vana Hercha. Number 6, Razor Wrecker. And number 80 is Beethoven's Fist. And they will be managed by Trailer Trash.
And the officials for tonight's game are head referee Patricide, inside pack Matthew Manch. Jammer refs are Catechism and Duke Skellington. Outside pack refs are DJ Jazzy Ref, Harmon Killebrew, and Rage Appropriate. And the referee alternate and assistant to announcers everywhere, Sidekick.
If you've got any questions for us, comments, nice things to say, reach out to us on Twitter using the handle at WFTDA Live and the hashtag TalkToWFTDA. Of course, that's talk and the numeral 2. WFTDA will try to answer some of your questions throughout the game, broadcast, and beyond.
Winner gets to play for 5th. The loser gets to play for 7th. Jet City wearing white. St. Chux wearing black. Pack in black wearing black.
Go figure.
Go figure.
Who do we have on the fast girl start line, Captain Lou?
Oh, I'm seeing Eva Derche for Jet City and Jedi Nightingale, who's been quite the star this weekend for the pack in black. Jamming away, Jedi Nightingale goes from the outside to the inside, dodges a hit from Nasty Nikki Nightstick, and she's off to the races with lead jammer. First lead jammer of the game going to St. Chux.
Nasty Nikki Nightstick is a force to be reckoned with, and almost took out that jammer, but speaking of jammers, we do have the first and second jammer penalty. Looks like a high block penalty being issued to the Jet City jammer, Eva Derche, immediately followed by a track cutting penalty issued to Jedi Nightingale. So they're both going to take a quick seat in the DerbySupply.net penalty box.
And we'll go with a full 2 minutes. First jam in. First one out of the box is Eva Derche. She engages that front of pack, and here comes Jedi Nightingale. She had completed her initial pass, so she does get 4 points. Nice hit by Whiplash forces Eva Derche out just before she hits turn 3. She's going to have to cycle her way back to the back of the pack. Still working on her initial pass. Jedi Nightingale with a nice little hop around, start a riot. Picks up another 5 points for the pack in black. Now at 9 in this jam. 54 seconds remaining in the first jam of this game. We will go the full 2 minutes as indicated. Jam cover is off. And star pass being attempted. Jedi Nightingale getting around Nasty Nikki Nightstick. That'll be pass number 3 for her. Now up to 14 points. Cycle back again in effect with Jet City having to reset one more time. Ill Ninja, the pivot. And there's the hop for Eva Derche. She gets through and the first 4 points of the game for Jet City are now on the board. Jedi Nightingale coming around. She's got 18, comes into the back of the wall, tumbles to the ground. Eva Derche looking for another hop past, but does not get it successful as the pivot Terra Eyes bumps her to the inside of the track. Jedi Nightingale now forced to the outside on turn one and drawn all the way to the back by Starter Riot. Eva Derici working her way through the front in the 2 minutes timeout. Three more points scored by St. Chux, four more by Jet City.
So in the early going, Captain Lou, it does seem like a bit of disorganization on both sides. They're trying to get their feet under them. This is, of course, the second game of the day for Jet City. They played at noon today with a squeaker defeating Columbia by 1 point, 134 to 133.
Yes, a thoroughly thrilling and exciting bout that I got to call with my good friend Dill Hero. Next jam underway with Wo Nelly taking the star for Jet City, and it's going to be number 14, Psycho Kid to Freak Out for St. Chuck's. But the first lead jammer of the game for Jet City has been achieved. Wo Nelly now looking for a chance to score. Psycho Kid with a nice spin move, getting around one blocker now with only one to beat, gets away. She will escape, trying to limit the scoring that Wo Nelly can do. Wo Nelly very cautiously approaching that pack in black. Bump to the inside, hands to the hips. We'll see what the scoring was. 3 points picked up by Wo Nelly.
Fast Girl Skates. Our mission is educating skaters. Get schooled. FastGirlSkates.com.
And on the Fast Girl start line is going to be number 3, Chicklets Rock for Jet City, and number 80, Connor, for the pack in black from St. Chuck's.
Jet City taking the back wall here. Nasty Nikki Nightstick, as we've often seen, looks like quarterbacking that rear three wall.
Yeah, she often hops right through, tries to provide a little bit of offense for her jammer, and then sets herself up at the front of the pack, which is good because Connor managed to get past the blockers at the back, and Nasty Nikki's Nightstick had to pick her up, allowed her blockers to come up and reform in front of her. Starter Riot now wreaking havoc on Connor. Connor trying to move back and forth. One to beat at the front of the back. Gets past Nasty Nikki Nightstick, picks up lead jammer for St. Chuck's.
Helmet cover comes off for Jet City. Currently still in the hand of Chicklets Rock, and Chicklets Rock is going to take it with her to the DerbySupply.net penalty box, having cut the track. This is now a power jam for St. Chuck's.
Second power jam of the game for St. Chuck's. This time they're keeping their jammer on the track. A little easier to score points that way. Nasty Nikki Nightstick. Last ditch hit on Connor, unsuccessful in slowing her down. Connor picks up 5 points, proceeds around the track one more time. Power jam continues, gives a little rolling signal to her blockers. Whiplash jumping forward, trying to provide a nice seal off. Forces Chantilly Cream to the outside. Connor's gear called off, 3 points grabbed.
Penalty had expired to Chicklets Rock, however, so there will be two jammers on the Fast Girl start line to get this next one underway. And you did see on that power jam pretty much immediate offense there by St. Chuck's. And none of that passive offense that we've seen a lot of this weekend.
Next jam getting ready to be lined up just behind the Fast Girl start line. Ivana Hurt, you taking a star. And once again, it's Jedi Nightingale. Jedi Nightingale in high rotation all weekend long, pushing up against that front three wall, getting some brace work in there. And that's going to slow her up just enough so that Ivana Hercha gets out first. Jedi Nightingale about 10 feet behind her and closing quickly. The pack is trying to figure out where they need to be. But the reality is that Ivana Hercha does not have the speed to keep herself in front of Jedi Nightingale. She's forced to call it off.
It looks like we have a prediction from the Talk to WFTDA feed here from Jenna Carroll. Says, well, if I'm going to have a kidney stone, I guess I'll watch the WFTDA Division II champs.
You think that's a prediction?
Well, it's a prediction, but it hasn't predicted who may be emerging.
She's just predicting
this
whether she'll have a kidney stone?
Perhaps, but keep it coming on Twitter at Talk to WFTDA.
Psycho Kid bumped out of bounds by Sia Wouldn't Wanna Be A, recycled to the back of the pack. Ava Derici working her way through, getting lead jammer. Still stuck and then hit hard. Little friendly fire incident in there, actually. Number 480, Pixie Destruction, put a hit on her own jammer, knocked her to the ground as she was being held up by the blockers from Jet City through the front of the pack and picking up 5 points. Ziva Derchi for it. Jet City and Cycle Kid still working to find their way out, but again, Sia wouldn't want to be in with the hit to the inside. And she picks up a forearm penalty. She'll go to the derbysupply.net penalty box to serve her 30 seconds. And Psycho Kid finally spins her way free from the pack. Eva Derchi gonna have to be careful with this scoring pass. She's gonna put the hands on the hips. No points for St. Chuck's and a single extra point grabbed for Jet City.
So at the 22 minutes plus on the period clock, your score, St. Chuck's 29, Jet City 17. Be a lifer, get a lifer, S1 Helmets. S1 Helmets are rad. Get rad at S1Helmets.com.
Get rad. So 22 minutes and 22 seconds remaining in the first half, a 12-point differential on the scoreboard. It's going to be Whoa Nelly for Jet City in number 18. Sugar Shock jamming for the Pack and Black. Sugar Shock stuck at the back, three wall bracing her, holding her back by Jet City. Getting through first is Whoa Nelly. Captain looking to draw her team closer, down by 12. Star Stash working out for Sugar Shock. She gets out of the pack now. Whoa Nelly is in the pack looking to score. She's got one blocker to beat in the front. Puts her hips past. Did she get that final point? The answer is yes. All four blocker points achieved.
So nice pickup there by Jet City. Compared to some of the games we've seen earlier today even, this is relatively penalty light. Not very many trips being taken to the derbysupply.net penalty box, Captain Luke.
That's right. I only see four on the St. Chuck side of the score or penalty board and only four on Jet City. So eight little penalties in the first 8.5 minutes. 29-21, St. Chuck's in the lead, jamming away. Jedi Nightingale trying to find that inside line, but greeted harshly by nasty Nikki Nightstick. She tumbles to the ground, has to reset at the back behind the formidable blocker from Jet City. Quickly through the pack, though, she found the space to use her agility to best effect. Lead jammer, Jedi Nightingale, still stuck in the pack as Chiclets Rock now getting out past Whiplash. She'll have an opportunity to slow down the scoring by Jedi Nightingale. Jedi Nightingale basically blowing a tire and spinning down into a 570. Calls it off from her knees.
That's a lot of rotations, Captain Lou.
It is.
But yeah, heads up call. Unable to get the get the feet back under her. Calls that jam before any damage can be incurred.
I mean, if anyone's been watching this weekend, Jedi Nightingale is the jammer you need to stop from St. Chuck. She's had 100-plus points in both games she's played so far.
And she's already got 25 today.
She already has 25 in the first 10 minutes of this game. Next jam underway, 20 minutes and 15 seconds remaining in the first half. Set to the back, Psycho Kid, the freakout by Salt and Peanut. And at the front, getting out for Jet City is Ivana Hurtcha. Jet City still behind by 12 points. Psycho Kid working her way on the outside line. Outside now, looks like she has a line, but no, bumped out of bounds. Gonna have to reset. Ivana Hurtcha is in the pack. Bumped out of bounds by Terrorize. She's gonna get drawn all the way back, but again with the jammer from St. Chuck still in that pack, unable to complete her initial pass, now completing her initial pass, but Ivana Hurtcha does have time to look at completing this first pass. We're unsure how many points she has. Bumped out of bounds again. We will see from the jammer ref all 5 points. Picks up that jammer lap point before she called it off.
We don't sell it if you wouldn't want to play in it. The first, the best, and happy to fix the rest. That is Sin City Skates. Find them online at SinCitySkates.com.
And on that fast girl start line, we're going to have Ava Derchi for Jet City going up against Connor from the Pack and Black. St. Chuck's jammer pinned at the back behind that braced tripod. And bumped out of bounds and being drawn back to turn four is Ava Derchi. She resets. Pack and Black able to set up a three wall at the back. Shifting laterally, nicely slowing down Ava Derchi. Ava Derchi trying to move her way to the front, but again bumped backwards and this time drawn back by Pixie Destruction at the front of the pack. Connor still working on that front wall, gets past Star to Riot, and she is your lead jammer.
And it took 30 seconds to achieve that status. But nice effort there by Connor. Meanwhile, Eva Durci, having been drawn back, has now removed the star from the helmet. Comes in hard behind Joni Rolmon. Has to reset yet once again. Drawback this time courtesy of Pixie Destruction.
Eva Durci resetting one more time. In the pack is Connor at the front, trying to pick up points. St. Chuck's currently leading by 7. The drawback by Ill Ninja continuing to bring Connor back all the way through the apex and finally making her way through the pack. 1:10 Eva Durci took to get out. And the first pass completed, she got the jammer lap point as well, and that's 5 points for Connor.
We saw Big Red with the big takeout there on the jammer over on the far straightaway, and just absorbing that and keeping going.
So 5 points in the previous jam by Jet City, 5 points in the last jam by St. Chuck's, trading the nickels back and forth, and we're back to a 12-point lead for St. Chuck's.
Both teams still have full complement of timeouts and official reviews at their disposal.
4-on-3 pack advantage for St. Chuck's. That will benefit Jedi Nightingale as she goes from the inside to the out, finds the line, gets lead jammer, still stuck in the pack. Whoa, Nelly. Now crashing up against the front of the pack. St. Chuck's having to stretch out. They will not contain her. She'll get out of the pack as well. Approaching the back of the pack, Jedi Nightingale is bumped to the inside. She has to reset. Nice, quick lateral movement. Goes straight to the outside line, falls to the ground, calls off the jam, and a forearm penalty is going to send, looks like it's going to send number 80, Beethoven's Fist, to the penalty box. 3 points grabbed by St. Chuck's.
So not too much seesawing happening on the scoreboard just yet. 41 for St. Chuck's. 28 points for Jet City. Still a differential of 13.
Psycho Kid to freak out up against Chiclets Rock. Psycho Kid working away through the front. Ill Ninja, Nasty Nikki Nightstick trying to work the duo blocking, but she manages to split the difference. Gets out, lead jammer going to Psycho Kid. Chiclets Rock trying to work her way out the front now to limit the scoring. She's got one to beat at the front of the pack as Psycho Kid approaches the back of the pack, enters on her scoring pass. Chiclet gets a no pass, no penalty, so she's able to get out. And Psycho Kid now slowing her down, playing a little jammer on jammer blocking. 5 points have been scored by Psycho Kid, and that's all she's going to get in this jam as she calls it off and ends it.
Adam skates, train hard, play smart, skate Adam. Adam's a proud partner of the WFTDA then and now. They're found at adamskates.com. So in the early going here, leading scorer of the game thus far is a Jedi Nightingale for St. Chuck's, having put up 28 points. Countering for Jet City, their leading scorer thus far is Eva Durci, number 13, who has 14 points.
Sugar Shock, Ivana Hertje, the jammers of record this go-round. 187, Zombie F-Bomb heading to the Derby Supply .net penalty box for a multiplayer block. Lead jammer achieved by Sugar Shock. Ivana Hertje about a quarter lap back. Sugar Shock enters the pack looking to pick up points. Knocked to the ground, calls it off from her knees. Did grab 2-1 plus the... I'll make that both blockers. No, there's anyone go to the penalty box? No one go to the penalty box. Only one from St. Chuck's in there.
Yeah, so a 20-point lead now for St. Chuck's. And, yeah, that is still Zombie F-Bomb serving the rest of her time in the DerbySupply.net penalty box. So a 4-3 pack advantage to start this one up for Jet City.
Penalty still very light in this game. Jedi Nightingale trying to find the outside line. Takes one hit from Sia, wouldn't want to be. Finished off by Starter Riot. So she has to recycle. And number 50, 50 Shades of Pink, really wanted a track cut but did not get it from the jammer ref as Eva Durci was cycled back. Out of play is going to send Sia, wouldn't want to be, to the penalty box. Whiplash also heading to the penalty box. So one blocker aside disappearing. Both jammers get out of the pack. Neither one of them wants to race anywhere, Mr. Whistler.
No, so a couple of donuts coming in for that jam. Still a 48-28, 13:40 left on the period clock. And as we've said already, penalties very light thus far. Only see one skater on either team sitting with two trips thus far. One is Zombie F-Bomb for St. Chux. And I stand corrected, the third one just appeared on the board for Sia Wouldn't Wanna Be A for Jet City.
So she's winning the race. You don't want to win the penalty race.
There are no prizes for that except an early trip to the locker room.
Whoa, Nelly getting lead jammer for Jet City as Cycle Kid to Freak Out gets cycled back and then is knocked to the inside by Beethoven's Fist. Beethoven's Fist trying to contain her. Nifty move by Cycle Kid to Freak Out, jumping to the inside. And a forearm penalty is going to send one of the blockers from Jet City to the penalty box. 5 points have been grabbed by Whoa Nelly and Cycle Kid to Freak Out, finally getting out of the pack. Chase is on. See if Whoa Nelly decides to risk it and try to get a point. She gets her hands and hips. Will she be granted anything? Nothing on the second pass.
Earlier in that jam, Big Red from St. Chux hit the deck hard near the pivot line. It was a little slow getting up. May have been just a little bit winded. Does complete the jam, though. Heads off to the bench, and we'll be back for more.
Yeah, and Big Red is one of those key blockers from SCDC. They need her out there. She's a solid presence, so they don't want her lose her to injury or fatigue.
No, indeed. And this 20-point lead down to now 14 points for St. Chux.
Il Ninja, who usually plays pivot on the track for Jet City, getting the star this go-around, picks up lead jammer for the Bombers from the West Coast. Connor has a star for the pack in black. She's got one to beat, gun to get by her. Chantilly Cream can't keep her in the pack. And a back block has been called. That back block has been assigned to Il Ninja. And Connor has been gifted with a power jam.
So with Il Ninja in that DerbySupply.net penalty box, an opportunity here for St. Chux to expand on that lead. Nasty Nikki Nightstick standing up while having nothing to do with that, making Connor work for it. Nasty Nikki Nightstick, though, lets her go, and that's a 5-point pass for St. Chux.
A nice awareness by the blocker from Jet City, was waiting for that out of play to be signaled. As soon as it was, she released. Started a riot trying to pitch in. One to beat, that one cannot contain Connor. Connor wanted to call it off. Connor, you are not the jammer. You cannot do so. You're going the full 2 minutes, even if you don't want to. 50 seconds remaining in this jam. Il Ninja back from the DerbySupply.net penalty box, back into the pack. Connor back into the pack, crashes into the wall, knocking down Chantilly Cream. Assaulted Peanut wanting a track cut, but no track cut had been committed. Connor now having to reset this time. Assaulted Peanut did get a piece of her. Il Ninja also knocked out of bounds. And we go from the front straightaway all the way back to the back straightaway as the pack continues to rotate in the anti-derby direction, as we like to call clockwise. 14 seconds left in the jam as the jammers re-enter the track. Whiplash with a knockout on Il Ninja. Il Ninja not paying attention to the fact that Whiplash was the one who knocked her out of bounds, picks up a track cut. She'll go back to the DerbySupply.net penalty box. And this next jam will start as a power jam as 3 points are grabbed by Jet City and one by St. Chux.
FXX wheels are the hottest wheels on the market. They're quad star certified from cutting edge technology. Find out more at bont.com. And indeed, this will be a power start for St. Chux. Jedi Nightingale is the St. Chux jammer starting on the Fast Girl start line.
I am not surprised in the least. Little bit of offense being played by St. Chux, trying to open things up. Big Red was the initiator of such, but now they go full passive as Jedi Nightingale wrestles her way through the pack, picks up lead jammer status. Pack at a standstill, full passive, grinding it down, but now leaping forward, Terror Eyes, creating the chaos that jammers do love. Jedi Nightingale taking advantage of it, grabs another 5 points for her team. Power jam is over. Jedi Nightingale with a hit on Il Ninja as she came out of the penalty box. Both jammers approaching the pack. Of course, Il Ninja is on her initial pass. She's got one to beat to try to get out. That one to beat is Big Red. Does get past her. And she should be able to limit the points here. Jedi Nightingale, a hip by Assaulted Peanut, sends her crashing to the ground. She grabbed 2 points, a little bit slow to get up, checks her hands, make sure they're both attached.
Both these teams playing their third game of the weekend, having gone 1-1 previously. St. Chux opened the tournament on Friday morning at 10 o'clock with a 10-point victory over Brandywine, 206-196, and then also played yesterday at 4, being taken out by Kansas City, 218-149. So this is, they're on the path, hopefully going towards fifth place. The winner, will that is, of this game will be playing for the fifth place game.
Penalty box is empty. 5-on-5 roller derby action ensues. Psycho Kid to Freak Out jamming for St. Chuck. She's at the front of the pack going up against Star to Riot and Nasty Nikki Nightstick. Chantilly Cream trying to keep her in the pack. Chicklets Rock being stuffed at the back by that pack in black blocking group. 50 Shades of Pink is going to draw her back to basically where she started, and lead jammer grabbed by St. Chuck's. Psycho Kid to Freak Out now approaching the back of the pack, starting her scoring pass. Chantilly Cream rotating to the front of the pack, gets the inverted shoulder pop, dropping Psycho Kid to Freak Out to the inside, forces the cycle back on her. But Chicklets Rock has just had no luck whatsoever. She's taken the star off of her helmet, looking to do the star stash, but still having trouble getting through that pack. Looks like she might escape finally. It's 50 Shades of Pink, gets the hands up and claims that she's no longer making contact. It's the I'm innocent, officer.
So a high five as Jet City comes off the track. And that was Chantilly Cream and Start a Riot. A little high five for their behavior on the far straightaway as they cause all sorts of problems there for Psycho Kid to Freak Out.
33 points. St. Chuck's has built their lead up 70-37. 6 minutes and 40 seconds remaining in the first half. Ivana Hirsch jamming for Jet City. Sugar Shock for the pack in black. Sugar Shock tries to go by on the inside. Beethoven's fist greets her, and it's going to be Ivana Hirsch who picks up lead jammer, Mr. Whistler.
Yes, indeed. And it's first lead jammer for a while. See what they can do with it. Trying to get that's differential on the scoreboard closer. Right now they're down by 33 points as St. Chuck's.
With the star off her helmet, Sugar Shock was pushing forward, pushing a bit too hard in an illegal zone known as the back. That grabs her a back block. She grabs a seat in the derbysupply.net penalty box, and it is now a power jam for Jet City. Now Jet City still trailing by those 33 points. Essential for them to put some points up on the board. Big Red cannot get Ivana Hirsch out of bounds. Ivana Hirsch gets past Big Red and has picked up 5 points for Jet City.
Yeah, all sorts of amazing footwork there by Ivana Hirsch at turn one as she managed to stay just inside the line. Again, sidestepping a takeout attempt there from Terrorize. Terrorize with that big wingspan on the legs. Really difficult blocker to get around.
Still working on her second scoring pass. Ivana Hirsch trying to make her way through. Out of the penalty box comes Sugar Shock, and she gets through the pack, completes that initial pass. That's going to force Ivana to call it off. Before she did, she had grabbed all 5 points, though, Mr. Whistler.
Yes, indeed. So 10-point pickup there for Jet City. Score 70-47. 5 minutes and 5 seconds is where the clock gets stopped. And an official review is being called by St. Chuck's.
An official review, the first of the half.
The first of the game. Made in the USA, made for Derby, Rydell skates offer unmatched quality and unmatched performance. Handcrafting quality roller skates for 70 years, RydellSkates.com.
Now, of course, we are trying to figure out who is going to be playing in the 5-game and the 7-game tomorrow. After this game, we will get Kansas City playing against Houston. That's for a chance to go to championships in St. Paul, Minnesota, play for the gold medal here in Cleveland, Ohio. If you lose that game, you have a chance to play for the bronze, but you do not get to go to champs.
That is correct, Captain Lou. And Demolition City has already punched a ticket with a bit of an upset, taking out the number one seed of this tournament, Santa Cruz, this afternoon, 165-137. So Demolition City will be playing tomorrow at 6 o'clock for the first place gold medal game here in Cleveland. And of course, championships coming up. St. Chux is on this review looking for a, I believe, a back blocking call is what Patricide said on one of the blockers.
That's right. So we'll see if they get any satisfaction from this request. But you know, Mr. Whistler, there are still games to be played today. There's one more game to be played today. There are five games to be played tomorrow. And quite honestly, for six games, if you're just sitting there at home listening to us on the audio feed, for $12, $2 a game, you could still watch all sorts of fantastic roller derby. There have been great games today. Lots of learning moments. Fantastic D2 action. If you have not been watching the D2s, I'm afraid you have missed out some great, great derby.
Well, and of course, I mean, some people might say, but there's a whole bunch of games that have already happened. So do I still want to pay that $12? Well, yes, indeed you do, because you're going to get access to all the archives, and of course you get to see the rest of this phenomenal weekend and this beautiful facility here in Cleveland, Ohio, the Cleveland Public Auditorium. They are skating on a wood floor. It's been a while since we've seen a wood floor in tournament play. It's a beautiful, beautiful room that we have here at our disposal.
It's pretty darn pretty.
And crew head referee Patricide is delivering a verdict on this official review to the bench staff. And perhaps our alter ref, who is sidekick for this game, will be able to pass on to our producer, Dill Hero, a bit more detail after this review.
And of course, as there is one more day left in the first of the D2s and the 10th anniversary of the WFTDA, there is, of course, another D2 being lined up next week in Detroit, Michigan. The second of the D2s will figure out who the other two teams that will go to champs are. And then after that, the D1s go. But for $12, you can get the Detroit D2, all 17 games. Don't be foolish. You know you should have paid that $12 for this weekend. You have missed some fantastic derby. Don't make the same mistake next weekend.
Oh, and if you are, of course, watching or even just listening to the audio stream, make sure you get in touch with us on Twitter. Hashtag, of course, is Talk2WFTDA. We want to know what you think, what you've seen so far.
See what Mr. Patricide has to say.
So Dill Hero is going to do a little research for us and get some more information about that review from the officials, and we'll have that for you shortly. What do we have on the Fast Girl start line, Captain Lee?
Fast Girl start line is going to have Eva Derici facing off against Jedi Nightingale. Jedi Nightingale looking for that outside line. Eva Derici works her way through her own wall of white that was at the back and now is getting stuffed at the front by the Pack and Black blockers. Bodies tumble to the ground, and it is Jedi Nightingale who gets out first, but she did not get out with lead jammer. That's going to go to Eva Derici. She escapes just in time before Jedi Nightingale can return and score points.
All your derby needs are available at derbysupply.net. Just hit it.
4 minutes and 30 seconds remaining in the first half. 70 for St. Chux, 47 for Jet City. 23 points separating these teams. Fast Girl start line is going to see Whoa Nelly and Connor. Jam underway. Razor Wrecker trying to provide some offense for Whoa Nelly. It is successful. Whoa Nelly gets out first. Lead jammer grabbed by Jet City. Connor still stuck at the back behind that Jet City blocking wall. Interestingly, though, Whoa Nelly picked the outside line. Connor followed her through. So that got her out of the pack. Whoa Nelly now calling it off. And Dill Hero.
Just a little update on that official review. It looked like St. Chux was looking for a back block that was caused. They said it's been happening all throughout this bout. But the referees felt like that the legal block is what pushed the skater out of bounds, not the little bit of a shove that actually did happen at the end of that. And that call will not stand.
So as a result, St. Chux does not retain their official review for this half.
5 points grabbed by Jet City on that last jam. 18 points separate these teams with 3 minutes remaining in the first half. Psycho Kid to freak out, pushing against that front braced tripod, now pushed to the outside. Chantilly Cream, Ill Ninja forming the back 2 being supported by Starter Riot. Chicklets Rock unable to find their way past the blockers from St. Chuck's. Now re-engaging at the back of the pack, pushed out of bounds one more time. And everyone's at a standstill. This pack is really stretched out, goes all the way from turn one, partway down the back straightaway. Now Chicklets Rock is working to close the gap between these skaters.
We actually had skaters from both teams contributing to that bridge work that was going on there.
Collaborative bridging, that will benefit Seko Kitty Freakout. She has lead jammer status. Wonelli has done the star pass to, or Chicklets Rock has done the star pass to Chantilly Cream. And she's approaching the back of the pack. Psycho Kitty gets 2 points, gives up 3 points. Hustle, hustle, hustle.
Dollar bill indeed.
High fives from her bench.
So we're under 2 minutes left here in the first half. Score 72 for St. Chuck's. Jet City at 55, only down by 17. Minute 40 left on the period clock.
Fast girl start line is going to get Jedi Nightingale. Ivana hurts you. Penalty box clear. 5-on-5 derby ensues. Number 19, the Mexorcist with a nice hit out on Jedi Nightingale. Forces the recycle, the reset to the back. Jedi Nightingale with some acceleration. But Ivana hurts you. Takes advantage of the 15 seconds she'd been granted by her blockers to pick up lead jammer. Half a lap back, Jedi Nightingale. Closing the gap quickly. Ivana Hertz is going to have to be very careful here. And she going to call it off in time? Not going to call it off in time. All 4 points grabbed by Jedi Nightingale.
Salted Peanut picking up a forearm penalty towards the end of that jam, taking a seat in the DerbySupply.net penalty box.
Now, in the first game of this playoff for Jet City, Starter Riot had 6 penalties in the first half. Nasty Nikki Nightstick, 5 penalties in the first half. They have had 0 trips to the penalty box, Mr. Whistler.
That is indeed a very impressive achievement compared to what we did see earlier this weekend. We've even seen some games this weekend with multiple foul outs for other teams. So we've got everybody staying on the track, and it's making things a little more difficult for the jammers. Not as much real estate.
Sugar Shock picking up lead jammer for St. Chuck's. Ava Derici does the star stash, gets out of the pack herself. Sugar Shock through the front, gets past Nasty Nikki Nightstick, picks up 4 points, calls it off. 80 for St. Chuck's, 58 for Jet City.
And nobody taking a timeout as we approach halftime. So right now, scoreboard showing 80 for St. Chuck's, Jet City at 58. That would be a deficit of 22 points.
Yeah, and you know, St. Chuck's is doing what they need to in order to win this game at the moment. But Jet City is doing what they did in the previous game against Columbia. They kept the score tight all the way through, and then they waited for Columbia to make mistakes. And when Columbia did make mistakes, Jet City was right there to close the gap and eventually win the game in that thrilling last jam. So St. Chuck's does have to be a little bit worried that they can't shake Jet City. And Jet City has to be a little bit happy that they haven't had the score blow apart on them.
No, indeed. And a very consistent game from both sides. Like, once they kind of achieved, okay, you're going to be in front, you're going to be right behind them.
Yep.
Not much seesawing, like I said, going back and forth on the scoreboard. St. Chuck's is holding to that lead and been kind of consistent on that difference. And we're not seeing penalties being a factor in this game at all either.
No. So we're going to take a bit of a break for halftime. We'll come back with all sorts of stats and numbers and 30 more minutes of roller derby action from Cleveland, Ohio, the Division II playoffs on WFTDA.TV. And we're back at the Public Auditorium in Cleveland, Ohio, for the Division II WFTDA playoff. Mr. Whistler, Captain Lou Obamo, and it's St. Chuck's versus Jet City. Fairly tight first half. St. Chuck's exerting their dominance a bit in the dying moments of that first half, but only able to get 22 points away. Pretty even for the most part.
Indeed. And one of the things we have discussed a lot this weekend is when penalties have been the story.
Yep.
And looking in a little more detailed here at the whiteboards, kind of the lack of penalties being the story right now.
Right. I mean, St. Chuck's only with 9 trips to that DerbySupply.net penalty box in the first half. Jet City with 15. Jet City committed a lot of penalties in their first game on Friday, but really cleaned up their game against Columbia earlier today, especially in the first half. Now, they got a little more vigorous. I've mentioned that Starter Riot and Nasty Nicky Nightstick, two of the heavy-hitting blockers from Jet City, have 0 trips to the penalty box. I wonder if they've sort of been holding themselves back in reserve and whether you'll see some of that physical nature that we're used to seeing from Jet City come to the forefront in the second half of this game.
Well, we might. I mean, there's also just been a lot of smart pack play from
there
both
has.
Of those skaters in this game, too, which is not to say that they were not smart previously, of course. One of the other close things that we're seeing, of course, are the jammer penalties.
Yes.
We've only seen 2 jammer penalties from St. Chuck's and 4 from Jet City.
Right.
Both relatively low numbers, but when those numbers are that low, a difference of 2-4 can be reflected on the scoreboard. And indeed, here we are with a 22-point difference.
22-point difference and a two power jam difference. That's not that surprising. 11 points on the power jam is not that unachievable a goal for most teams. Interestingly, on the Jet City side, they have 2 jammers that are at 80% lead jammer percentage. Ivana Hirchi and Wo Nelly have had great success, but they've been jammed in very limited capacity. 5 jams each, 4-for-5 getting out of the pack first. Over on the St. Chuck's side, you're looking at Connor, Psycho Kitty Freakout, and Sugar Shock, all at 50%. Surprisingly, Jedi Nightingale has not had that much success, though she is the lead scorer for St. Chuck's.
In fact, she's the lead scorer of the game, the leading point getter. She has earned 39 of St. Chuck's 80 points, which is 1 less than 50%, if my announcer math is correct. On the Jet City side of the ledger, Wo Nelly with 20 of Jet City's 58 points. Ivana Hircha has 18, so those two accounting for the majority. That being said, Ava Durchi with 14. So they're kind of spreading things out a little more democratically on the Jet City Bombers side.
We are moments away from getting the second half underway. 30 more minutes to determine who plays for fifth and who plays for seventh. We could have rematches from the first day if it all works out. St. Chuck's, if they win, would play against Brandywine for fifth at 2 p.m. And if Jet City lost, they would play OKVD at noon for seventh. Both teams with an opportunity to improve their seeding as well, Mr. Whistler.
Indeed. And we have a lead jam already earned here by a Jedi Nightingale. This is a 4-2 pack advantage off the Fast Girls start line for St. Chuck's.
That's
two
right.
Jammers starting in the box for Jet City were Beethoven's Fist and Assaulted Peanut, both back out on the track. And meanwhile, Jedi Nightingale with a 5-point pass has the grand slam to get St. Chuck's started in the second half.
Star Stash working for Wo Nelly. She's out of the pack as well now. Back into the pack as Jedi Nightingale pushed to the outside. Going to have to reset, does so quickly behind Singria, comes out the front, grabs 4 points, but 3 points snagged by Wo Nelly. Again, good hustle on the part of the jammers from Jet City.
So after that first jam of the second half, score now 89 for St. Chuck's, 61 for Jet City. That's a 28-point lead for St. Chuck's. Both teams still have all 3 of their team timeouts at their disposal, and of course their official reviews have been restored for the second half.
Night Glider and Trail of Trash, good at controlling the time, and with all the weapons at hand still. Chiclets Rock getting lead jammer for Jet City. Psycho Kitty Freakout with 1 to beat at the front at Start a Riot. Now Nasty Nicky Nightstick comes up to provide support. Not going to keep Psycho Kitty Freakout in the pack, but Chiclets Rock is through. Picks up 5 points and then calls it off.
See, Nasty Nicky Nightstick actually leaving the track a little bit slowly, taking a knock earlier in that jam, is getting off under her own power. Will be back for no doubt on the next jam.
No doubt she is in regular rotation.
The jammer rotation coming in now on the Fast Girls start line. Number 80, that's going to be Connor for St. Chuck's, and 13, Ava Derchi for Jet City.
Jet City with a back line allows Ava Derchi to move around the outside and push that wall of black forward. Picks up lead jammer on turn number 1. Now Connor trying to accelerate her way through the front of the pack. Track cut is going to remove one of the blockers from the Jet City wall. Connor getting out of the pack now. In the back of the pack, having made her first lap after the initial pass, is Ava Derchi, going to have to call it off, grabbing 3 points. Jet City crawls ever closer. They are now within 20 points.
And that was Mexorcist taking her first trip to the DerbySupply.net penalty box for Jet City. This will be a 4-3 pack advantage for St. Chuck's when this one gets underway. Jedi Nightingale, again, currently the leading point getter in this game, has 48 thus far for St. Chuck's on that fast girl start line.
Number five, Ivana Hirsch, with 18 points so far in this game. Jammers pushing against each other. Now, St. Chuck's has the back wall this go-round, and that is one of the reasons that Jedi Nightingale was trying to seal off Ivana Hirsch, is successfully doing so. She gets out of the pack first, tumbling to the ground.
It's Tara Eyes, but she's back up in a hurry. Once again with the backwards skating, running that triangle.
Yeah, that braced wall working out very well for St. Chuck's, holding back Ivana Hirsch. A Jedi Nightingale completes her first scoring pass, grabs 5 points. It is Big Red who has to let Ivana Hirsch go, but Jedi Nightingale completing the second scoring pass and grabs another 5 points. Jedi Nightingale coming up on the back, Ivana Hirsch being stuffed by the pack and black wall. Ivana Hirsch through, picks up 4, Jedi Nightingale calls it off. Cataclysm consulting with the referees on the track to figure out the number of points are going to be assigned. And at some point in time, we'll find out. The answer is 5.
The pack speed has definitely picked it up here in the second half. In general, this entire game, pack speed has actually been a bit on the fast side compared to some of the other action we have seen here this weekend. And that could very well be a factor in some of these penalties. We're seeing a lot less of those kind of clustering stop block sort of penalties that we've seen earlier this weekend.
St. Chuck's again getting the back line able to hold up. Wonelli, lead jammer, is going to go to number 14, Psycho Kitty Freakout. Now approaching the front of the pack once again. Only 2 blockers on the track. Wonelli has done the star stash. Assaulted Peanut returning from the DerbySupply.net penalty box to join her blockers on the track, trying to hold back Psycho Kitty Freakout. Psycho Kitty Freakout has completed her first scoring pass, has grabbed 5 points for her team. Still stuck in that pack is Wonelli, trying to get out. Wonelli still stuck at the back of the pack. And it's going to be Psycho Kitty spinning around the front 2 blockers from Jet City. Another scoring pass. Attempted star pass. Star pass complete. The jammer of note for Jet City is Syngria. Syngria does get knocked out of bounds. The one's going to have to recycle one more time. Psycho Kitty Freakout having a huge jam for St. Chuck's. A game-changing jam, Mr. Whistler.
Yeah, she is just scoring at will. I mean, she is held up at turn 4 right now behind Wonelli, who is now blocking for Jet City. But she's putting up big numbers. She's already at 60 on the game.
And penalties were not a problem in the first half. They have become a problem in the second half for Jet City, as they do have 2 blockers in the penalty box. One of those blockers is Wonelli, who was the jammer to start, but is just a regular blocker now. Psycho Kitty Freakout with another 5 points. Finally getting through is Syngria. A minute and 40 seconds it took for Jet City to get their jammer out of the pack. Psycho Kitty Freakout exits the pack backwards, stumbles a bit after calling it off, but grabs another 4 points, and St. Chuck's has grown their lead. It is 125 to 73, 52 points all of a sudden.
Yeah, so Jet City is going to take a team timeout. They're all coming out actually away from their bench. They're having this team timeout right on the outside of the line.
It's an aggressive team timeout.
Yes. And so Jetty Nightingale now up to 60 points on the game. Again, right around 50% mark. St. Chuck's has 125, Jet City at 73. All of a sudden, this is a 52-point lead for St. Chuck's. 23 minutes, 39 seconds left in the half.
So you have to wonder if it's something that St. Chux has figured out on Jet City, or if it's Jet City just sort of feeling a bit of fatigue, having played that first game against a tough Columbia team earlier on today.
And that was a tough game.
It was. They
were 134 to 133.
Yep.
I think we had three jams in the final minute of the period clock.
Yeah, it was a pretty exciting game. If you weren't watching it, you should have had the broadcast bought on WFTDA.tv. Only $12 for the D2s, $15 for the D1s. $60 buys you the D1s and championships. Make sure you get your pass purchased in time to watch us on WFTDA.tv. Jamming away with Chiclets Rock, taking the star for Jet City. Sugar Shock jamming four. St. Chuck's front of the pack only has one blocker remaining for the pack in black. She's not going to be able to hold back Chiclets Rock. And Big Red had to let her go. No, it is a track cut. She did get enough of her to knock her out of bounds and enter back in. So congratulations to Big Red forcing that track cut. It is the blocker's dream come true.
And that was very good timing there for St. Chuck's, because they were briefly down to only two blockers on the track. Now they can just turn to complete offense here.
The jammer now has become Terra Eyes. And we'll go the full 2 minutes. Minute left in this jam. Returning to the track is Chiclets Rock. Chiclets Rock bumped to the outside, and the entire pack in black is going to draw her back. She got bumped out just entering turn one. She has to come back all the way to turn four.
Yeah, Zombie F-bomb with the takeout, and then the drawback picked up by Big Red. Nice tandem on that takeout and drawback.
Terrorize manages to split her way between Woe Nelly and Nasty Nikki Nightstick at the front of the pack, grabs 5 points. Chiclets Rock gets out of the pack on her initial pass. Again, there is no lead jammer. Jam will go to its natural conclusion in another 20 seconds. Chiclets Rock will grab 4 points for Jet City. Terrorize, the pivot turn jammer after the star pass, having to reset at the back of the pack one more time. Time ticking down on this jam. 10 seconds remaining. Chiclets Rock runs up against Zombie F-Bomb, trying to get past Big Red at the front of the pack. Big Red already forcing one penalty on her, but Big Red stretched way too far out of bounds. Going to go to the DerbySupply.net penalty box for a out of play block. 5 points for Jet City, 4 for St. Chuck's.
Jackson skate for the love of it. Jackson skates. And scoreboard currently showing 134 for St. Chuck's, 82 for Jet City, 21-20 on the period clock, Captain Lou. And at this point in time, again, 52-point lead for St. Chuck's. They haven't quite put the pedal to the metal, though.
No, they had that one big jam. We'll see if they can duplicate it, but it's going to be Ava Derchi getting through first, with Jedi Nightingale being held up by the blockers of Jet City. Jet City with all their blockers on the track. When they have four out there, they are formidable foes. Jedi Nightingale pushed to the outside. Ava Derchi approaching the back of the pack. Collides with Pixie Destruction and Whiplash. She's going to get through first and foremost. 4 points, yes, as Jedi Nightingale had escaped. So no jammer lap point grabbed.
Razor Wrecker for Jet City taking the out of play blocking penalty, taking a seat in that DerbySupply.net penalty box. For all your derby needs, DerbySupply.net, just hit it.
Getting a little more action in the second half, that penalty box.
Psycho Kid to freak out on the Fast Girls start line for St. Chuck's.
And Ivana Hercher for Jet City. Ivana Hercher with a quick lateral move from the inside to the center of the track, knocked down that four wall of St. Chuck's blockers, turns into a three wall, rather loose blocking tripod, trying to hold her back. But they're doing a good job, pushed her out of bounds, and that's going to get Psycho Kitty an opportunity to get through the front. Only Nasty Nikki Nightstick to beat. She does get lead jammer, but she also gets knocked out of bounds. It's one of those occasions where you get lead, but you got to cycle all the way back. Loses a quarter track, and that's going to let Ivana Hurt you get out of the pack. Psycho Kitty is just going to call it off. No points going to get scored this time round.
That's a rare shutdown for Psycho Kitty. As all of a sudden, Jet City has her number. They swarmed her. And of course, the big takeout there by Nasty Nikki Nightstick. And then the drawback. That's going to put the door on that jam.
Nasty Nicky Nightstick and Starter Riot still playing a completely clean slate in this game. On the fast girl start line, Connor facing off against Il Ninja. Il Ninja, the alt jammer, coming in. A little bit of success in the first half. Knocked to the ground this time by Pixie Destruction. Three blockers at the back. Salted Peanut trying to play some offense. Not going to be able to get Il Ninja out first. It is going to be Connor getting out the front of the pack. The blockers from Jet City unable to contain her. Now coming around on a scoring pass. Weaves to the outside between turn one and two. Now coming down to back straightaway as Sangria goes inverted. Little truck and trailer, but they've got to let her go. Mexicist. And a track cut. A track cut has been forced on Il Ninja. She'll go to the DerbySupply.net penalty box, and it is Connor who has a power jam. So a little bit of a slip up by Jet City. St. Chuck's with a big opportunity to stretch this lead.
So Jet City now going to strict defense up front there. Triangle, though, gets broken apart by Connor. Connor's going to call it. Connor a bit beat, I think, after that jam, and they're going to put fresh legs out to carry on with this power jam. Score 144 for St. Chuck's, 86 for Jet City, 17 minutes plus on the period clock.
Yeah, I kind of like that strategy. A lot of these jams have really been stretching out. A lot of people getting really worn out again. Second game of the day for Jet City. Second game of the tournament for, third game of the tournament for St. Chuck's. You want to conserve your energy for the last 17 and a half minutes. So getting new legs, fresher legs out there in the form of Jedi Nightingale, not the worst idea, although there are four blockers for Jet City. They tried a gang rusher to the inside. She resets so quickly, though, when it spins around the outside. Can't be stopped by Starter Riot and Nasty Nicky Nightstick. Going to get lead jammer in already around the pack. Power jammer is over. Il Ninja out of the penalty box. Trying to engage and work her way through the back of the pack. Spinning around at the front is Jedi Nightingale, engaging those tough hitting blockers from Jet City. Starter Riot does get a piece of her, knocks her out of bounds, forces her back from turn one to halfway back down the front straightaway. Back straightaway does see Il Ninja get out of the pack, so Jedi Nightingale will just call it off, having grabbed 4 points.
So a bit of passive offense on that power start for St. Chuck's, but it pays off. Only took 10 seconds to pick up that lead jammer status and was back on that scoring pass under 20. No points come in for Jet City. So 148-86 St. Chuck's, 16:25 on the period clock.
Fast girl start line has Psycho Kitty Freakout for St. Chuck's, and it is Chiclets Rock. For Jet City, Chiclet Rocks has the outside line, tries to accelerate things forward, but it gets stalled. Psycho Kitty Freakout keeps the feet moving. She's got the Jet City tripod up at the front, but now she gets stalled out. And last ditch hit by Whiplash does bump Chiclet Rock out of bounds as she achieves lead jammer. So we're going to have another one of those jams where the lead jammer gets sucked back into the pack.
Psycho Kitty completes the initial pass, and that is when Chiclets Rock is going to call it. And Captain Lou, of course, this weekend we're seeing, you know, the introduction of all the wonderful 2015 tournament
yes.
merchandise. But if you missed out on exclusive 2014 playoffs and championships merchandise, you can complete your collection at the WFTDA online store. Go to the WFTDA website at WFTDA.com/store.
Next jam gets started with Sugar Shock going up against Ava Dare. Chase St. Chuck's 148, Jet City 86, 15 minutes remaining in this game. Winner goes to the fifth place game. Loser goes to the seventh place game. Up at the front, one to beat. Big Red has to let her go. Tried to get a hip on her, but it's Ivaderci who gets lead jammer for Jet City. Jet City needing to make a move if they want to catch St. Chuck's. St. Chuck's trying to get their jammer out of the pack. Sugar Shock stuck at the back, still being worked over by Start a Riot. Chantilly Cream almost through the front of the pack was Ivaderci trying to complete that first scoring pass, but she's going to get dragged half a lap back by the pack in black. Gonna have to reset. She does still have time, though. Sugar Shock has not been able to make her way out. That tripod at the front is Nasty Nicky Nightstick, Chantilly Cream, and Starter Ride holding her down. Sia wouldn't want to be a springing back, trying to create some chaos in that pack and black wall. Direction of gameplay. is going to send. See, one wouldn't want to be into the belly box. And that's enough for Iwaderchi, I think.
Yeah, it's basically all the bodies that hit the deck there. You kind of knew at the bottom of that pile there was somebody. And, yes, it did turn out to be Siowin Wanabia, who was the one being issued that direction of gameplay penalty. So now taking a seat in the DerbySupply.net penalty box. It's going to be a 3-2 pack advantage for St. Chuck's as this one gets underway.
That does not bode well for Jet City, as any time that Jedi Nightingale has a little extra room, she takes advantage of it quickly. Little bit of jammer on jammer defense on the outside. Assaulted Peanut had a piece of Jedi Nightingale and went to the penalty box on the forearm. Jedi Nightingale gets past a lone blocker left on the track, does get lead jammer status. And a track cut. A track cut on Ivana Herchez sent her to the DerbySupply.net penalty box. And Jedi Nightingale, not who you want on the track, with a power jam, has 5, adding to the 64 she already had in this game. That'll be 69 points, Mr. Whistler.
Indeed. And so we briefly had a full box there for Jet City. And as the two blockers escape, Assaulted Peanut now, there's room for her, the pivot of Jet City. So the two helmet covers for Jet City, both in the DerbySupply.net penalty box. St. Chuck's having the big advantage on the track right now.
Yeah, it seems like St. Chuck's is just starting to bring it all together in this second half. 12 minutes and 40 seconds remaining in the game, 1 minute remaining in the jam. Power jam is over. Jedi Nightingale continuing to score points. 163-90 is the score. Ivana Hirsch is still trying to complete that initial scoring pass. She gets bumped out of bounds by Whiplash and has to recycle one more time. Multiplayer block is going to send Star to Riot to the DerbySupply.net penalty box. Jedi Nightingale through for another 4 points. Ivana Hirsch is still trying to get through the front. One to beat at Zombie F-Bomb. Finally, 90 seconds through the jam before she achieves her first pass. Jedi Nightingale nice and low through the front. One more time for 4 points and a timeout called by Trailer Trash of Jet City.
Yeah, on that last pass, Jedi Nightingale does indeed get so low. We saw Siowin Wanabia with the backwards flip there with the hip going out for that takeout. And we actually saw a Jedi Nightingale skate under the hips and missed it entirely and stayed in bounds
at speed.
Phenomenal skating there by Jedi Nightingale, who is still up just now over 50% of St. Chuck's points. Jedi Nightingale with 87 on the board, and St. Chuck's with 171 total. Jet City at 90. They're going to take this timeout and see what they can do with it. 12:03 left on the period clock, Captain Lou.
And you know, Mr. Whistler, you would think normally if a jammer had 87 points, we're going, man, that jammer is having a very good game. But this is actually less points than Jedi Nightingale usually scores in the games, at least this weekend. With those 100 pluses, we'll see if she's able to get past that century mark. But as it is, we will get Roller Derby back underway again. 12 minutes and 3 seconds remaining in this game. It's going to be Psycho Kitty Freakout taking the star for SCDC. Whoa Nelly doing the job for Jet City. Bombers needing to pull something out of their bag of tricks in order to be able to close the gap, down by 81 points to Pack and Black. Whoa Nelly working her way through the front of the pack. She's got 2 to beat, goes down to 1 to beat, and is going to get through, spins around, and picks up lead jammer.
So Trailer Trash obviously drops some sort of a bomb of wisdom here, because Whoa Nelly taking advantage here with the lead status. Direction of gameplay penalty being issued to Shaquilla from St. Chuck's.
Out of the pack now is Psycho Kitty Freakout heading to the penalty box. Is Sia Wouldn't Want to Be a. That is going to be trip number 5 for her. She's getting towards that number 7 mark. 50 Shades of Pink has 4 on SCDC's side.
The WFTDA would like to thank 5on5 Magazine, Something Inked, and also DerbySupply.net.
On the Fast Girls start line, we're going to have Connor taking the star for SCDC. Chick Let's Rock for Jet City. Connor to the inside, now to the outside. Absorbs a hit from number 6, Razor Wrecker. Again, quick lateral movement by Connor, but not a lot of forward momentum. We're going to get through first as Chick lets rock, and Connor still weaving back and forth. A little bit of offense going into play, 50 shades of pink. Whiplash trying to provide that offense for their jammer. Connor now with only one to beat up the front. Chick lets rock, gets through the pack, picks up 4 points. Looking to pick up that jammer lap point, but I don't know if it's necessarily worth it with that little time left on the clock, 10 and a half minutes to go. They've got some room to make up. They call off the jam.
Yeah, Zombie F-Bomb also now starting to get into some penalty trouble for St. Chux, having picked up her fifth box trip on that jam for a multiplayer block. Zombie F-Bomb has done some phenomenal work in the pack this weekend for the pack in black.
We've got a 4 and a 4-4 on the track right now, Mr. Whistler. It's kind of palindromic.
It's sort of, but not 100% palindromic, although there is an 11 out there too. We could do some math. The 4-4, however, is now off the track, taking a seat in the DerbySupply.net penalty box. This is a power jam for St. Chux.
However, there's a skater down on the outside track. I'm just checking to see who the number
that
is on it.
That would be Big Red from
yep.
St. Chux.
I mentioned that she had gone down hard earlier in the first half, going down second time. EMTs coming out to check her out, making sure that she's okay, lying back. So we'll get ourselves a bit of an injury timeout. That jam getting called off. It was a power jam underway when it had been called off.
Let's have a look at the whiteboards. We are seeing a skater on each team sitting on 5 box trips. Again, as we were saying, Zombie F-Bomb from St. Chux having served, well, still serving her fifth. And number one, Sea Wouldn't Want to Be a from Jet City, also on 5. Number of clean slots there, though, on the St. Chux side, which could, again, very well be part of the story here. Relatively unpenalized in comparison. Big Red is getting up under her own power.
Excellent.
And
moves
on her own wheels. Is favoring her right leg just a little bit, but is able to skate to the bench under her own power.
Well, with the lead that St. Chux has built up, I suspect that they'll be able to rest her a little bit as we go into the last 9 minutes and 40 seconds of this game. 171 for St. Chux, 96 for Jet City is the current score. Jedi Nightingale will go back on the track. She does have a power start. She will resume where she left off after that injury forced the last call off. It is a 3-on-2 pack advantage in favor of Jet City, but they are missing their jammer, and that is not ever how you want to start a jam.
It is not indeed. But it looks like the pivot for Jet City, Sangria, setting up the triangle. And then just right off the bat, textbook offense there from St. Chux. As Whiplash and Pixie Destruction clear the three of them right into the middle, open up the inside lane. And now Jedi Nightingale going back for a very quick 5-point pass.
Yeah, nice little hop over the Mexorcist, picks up those 5 points. Now at 92, closing in on that century mark. Once again, making that bid for tournament MVP. Someone's going to get selected. And you got to think that someone who's picking up 100 points a game for a team might be one of those people. We'll have to see tomorrow if you watch all the way through. Sangria now gets out of the pack as well. Jedi Nightingale calls it off, grabs 5. And a timeout, official review being asked for by St. Chux and Nightglider.
And checking the Talk to WFTDA Twitter feed, right after you said that, our producer, Dill Hero, hands over the phone, and sure enough, Knox agrees with you, apparently, having said this independently. Jedi Nightingale for Tournament MVP is the tweet. Thank you, Knox, for tuning in and checking in on Talk to WFTDA.
If you ever pay attention to the things that Knox says, she usually says pretty smart things out there in the Derbyverse, so I'm not surprised that Knox and I are thinking exactly the same thing at this time.
Hashtag compliments for Captain Lou.
Hey, or Knox.
Well, fishing is actually maybe
fishing,
the hashtag I'm
right.
looking for. So Patricide will have an announcement imminently about what the nature of this official review is.
Wow, that's pretty straightforward. St. Chuck's asking for a back block penalty on the Jet City jammer.
Yeah. So we will have to see if indeed they are able to acquire such a penalty. There is, of course, one more game happening here today.
It's a somewhat important game.
Oh, it's a very important game because that game will feature Houston versus Kansas City. That game happening at 8 o'clock. Kansas City and Houston both aiming to see who will go to the first place game tomorrow. And also, just by virtue of playing in that game, you automatically get with it a ticket to Minneapolis-St. Paul in
That's
November.
That's right. That's the golden ticket. You know you want to win that game, and you'll be facing off whoever wins that game against Demolition City, who took out Santa Cruz. Santa Cruz, a very tough, strong team, the number one seed. And Demolition City came in, took everything that they had, and still walked away with the victory.
And, of course, whatever happens in this game will set up a rematch one way or the other. We would have a potential rematch of the second game of the weekend between Jets City and Oklahoma City if this score holds.
Yeah, the victory dolls for sure, yep.
However, if it goes the other way, we have that reversed, do we?
Yeah, now if Jet City loses, they will face off against the Oklahoma Victory Dolls, and if St. Chuck's wins, they'll face off against Brandywine.
Okay, so that is where how I was reading that. Yes. The arrows, there were so many arrows, they were so confusing.
So yeah, I mean, it's one of those rare occasions on this 10-team bracket, the way it's set up, that sometimes you can get teams facing off for a second time that weekend, but everything has to fall exactly right. It's ultra rare to have two sets of teams ending up having rematches. And on top of that, the teams will all have, both of these teams at least, will have an opportunity to at least come out of this tournament with their seed matched. That is assuming that Jet City cannot come back from this 85-point deficit that they're at right now. There's still 9 minutes. There is that opportunity for Jet City to come back. But Jet City coming in as an 8 seed in this tournament, currently right now, no matter what happens, they're going to leave with at least their seed intact, but still an opportunity to improve upon their seed.
Here comes Patricide with the verdict.
And very succinct by Patricide, the head referee, said after review, no penalty was committed. That means the official review is done and they do not retain it.
St. Chuck's does still have all three of their team timeouts at their disposal, however.
If they want to stop the clock.
If they want to stop the clock.
So with 8 minutes and 59 seconds remaining and a substantial lead over St. Chuck's, 85 points. I suspect they will be happy to, or over Jet City, they will be happy to get this game done as quickly as they can possibly can at the moment. Iwaderchi trying to shift momentum back to Jet City. Psycho Kitty freak out, trying to get out first for St. Chuck's. That's not going to happen as Iwaderchi is your lead jammer.
St. Chuck's now bleeding skaters from the track. Had a multiplayer block penalty issued to Joni Rolmon.
And a track cut penalty issued to Psycho Kitty Freakout. So
Jet City basically clears the bases on that one, as in order it goes blocker, pivot, jammer, and the box has filled for St. Chuck's.
So the penalties for the cycle, pretty much. Iwaderchi and Whiplash. The Whiplash probably about 40 feet out of play, going to head to the derbysupply.net penalty box. Sometimes you push a little bit too hard and it just doesn't work out for you. Now only one blocker left on the track. Not having a lot of luck. 50 shades of pink as they're basically ganging up on her, isolating her. Iwaderchi, again, continuing to cycle around this track untouched, doing speed laps. Power jam is over. Psycho Kitty Freakout back out of the derbysupply.net penalty box, trying to come through on her initial pass. And bumped to the inside by El Ninja, stays in bounds, now coming up at the front. Nasty Nikki Nightstick, not going to be able to keep her in there, skates out of the front of the pack backwards. And we force Iwaderchi to call it off, but Iwaderchi with another 4 points. A big jam for Jet City. They make a little bit of a dent, got it down to 61 points with 7 minutes and 17 seconds left in this game, Mr. Whistler.
Yeah, it was a 14-point jam for Iwaderchi. Iwaderchi is the leading point getter for Jet City at this point in the game with 49 thus far. Skating quite cleanly as well. Only one trip to the derbysupply.net penalty box thus far.
Sia wouldn't want to be a, who is in that penalty box, is sitting on 6 trips, so she is in that ultra danger zone. One more trip will send her to the dressing room. Jamming away with Ivana Hercha, wearing the star against Sugar Shock. Ivana Hercha pushed to the outside. Pixie Destruction setting up the big drawback to turn 4. At the front, a tripod set up, holding back Sugar Shock. Slowly making a little bit of progress at the front. Beethoven's Fist and the Salted Peanut holding the back 2 brace of that wall. And pushed to the outside once again by Whiplash is Ivana Hercha. She has to reset. 30 seconds gone in this jam. Neither jammer able to make headway. 4 blockers holding back from in the pack in black. Little bit of assist there coming from C. Wouldn't want to be as she comes from the penalty box trying to play some offense, but picks up that penalty. That was number 7, Mr. Whistler. I do believe that she'll be done for the day.
She will. And also joining her at the derbysupply.net penalty box, number 41, Assaulted Peanut. I believe that'll be trip number 5 once it gets updated.
45 seconds of holding down the jammer turns into 2 trips to the penalty box for blockers from Jet City and Sugar Shock picking up lead jammer. She's back around the track. Now that truck and trailer working wonders to hold her back, slow her down. But quite honestly, points are not the most important thing for Sugar Shock at the moment. Every second she take off the clock is another second that puts St. Chuck's closer to winning this game. Sugar Shack again slowly crawling towards turn 1. Singria spins around, finally gets out the jammer from Jet City, but Jan's gonna get called off. 5 points for St. Chuck's.
Whiplash a little slow to get up, and I think that was more of a, yeah, I had a bit of a fall down, go boom, and just like, okay, yes, that happened. So she's fine, though. It was not a hard hit. There were big smiles when she got back up on her feet. Just under 5 minutes left. Scoreboard 186 for St. Chuck's, 120 for Jet City. 66 point difference.
Jet City needing the Hail Mary pass now in order to be able to close this gap with a 66 point gap, as you mentioned. Mr. Whistler, Bonelli goes outside, comes inside, picks up lead jammer. Jedi Nightingale still stuck in that pack. Jedi Nightingale with 97 points in this game, but being stuffed by Jet City, now getting out of the pack for her team, able to limit the scoring by Wonelli. Wonelli coming up at the front. Only one to beat. That one is Joni Ramon. Bumped to the inside. Did she grab all 4? No, 3 points. Joni Ramon saves her point.
No points come in, though, for St. Chuck's. So score differential now down to 63 points. 4 minutes left on the period clock here in Cleveland. Performance plates for the modern derby game, Paradyne. Paradyne has cutting-edge designs and cutting-edge performance.
Chiclets Rock going up against Psycho Kitty Freakout. 3 minutes and 40 seconds left in this game. Chiclets Rock being gang-rushed to the outside. Bodies tumbling to the ground. Chiclets Rock hit in the head by Whiplash. Whiplash going to the penalty box for the high block, but the amount of time it took for Chiclets Rock to get up again was enough to get Psycho Kitty Freakout through the pack. With only 3 minutes and 25 seconds left in this game, Psycho Kitty Freakout's going to call it off, spin around on her toe stops once or twice, picks up those 3 points.
Official review being requested by the Jet City Bombers. Clock is going to stop at 3:14 left.
St. Chuck's in a commanding lead at the moment with only 3 minutes and 15 seconds to go. I mean, 66 points is a lot of points put up in a short period of time. The Jet City using their official review, which means they'll have one more chance to stop the clock, unless, of course, they win this official review, then they will retain it.
And Captain, this is a good time to remind everyone that this year the WFTDA is celebrating 10 years of leadership in modern roller derby. Since 2005, the WFTDA has grown from 20 leagues to more than 400, which represents a growth of, here's a stat, 1,970%.
That is a lot of percent.
That's a very large amount of percent. It almost sounds like a metric number.
Us Canadians, always ruining everything, or the rest of the world anyways.
Waiting to see if Patricide's about to announce the question has been asked. It's like Derby Jeopardy. You have to respond in the form of a question. Here it comes.
Eva Derici, it looks like.
St. Chux is requesting a review of the high block penalty.
St. Chux is requesting the review of the high block penalty that.
That's interesting.
Was assessed because we are seeing Connor, the wearing the Jammer Star, in the DerbySupply.net penalty box right now for St. Chux.
We are.
So while the thought was not completed on the microphone, I would imagine that that is the penalty that they're trying to get overturned.
It could be. Now, St. Chux, as far as I know, doesn't have an official review. This is indicated as Jet Cities. So I'm just wondering if perhaps Patricide may have misspoke which team is requesting review of the high block. There was the hard hit on the Jammer, Chiclets Rock, which resulted in.
And now, as we haven't even had a discussion or a decision made,
no.
Connor is no longer wearing the star in the penalty box, and Jedi Nightingale is back on the Fast Girl start line.
All right. Well, we'll get clarification for you when we can. However, if you want to talk to us on the Twitters, hashtag talk to WFTDA, and of course, you can find out all sorts of interesting bits of information by following at WFTDA Live for live tweets of the WFTDA playoffs and championships.
Not to mention on Instagram, search for WFTDA on Instagram. Marketing manager for the WFTDA, Mia Culprit, has been making the rounds, documenting this incredible weekend on the Instagram.
So much social media. Now we're just watching to see if Patricide's going to speak. We do not want to talk over him, especially when you get to hear his lovely voice. Referee from Montreal Roller Derby making the trip to Cleveland, Ohio for this Division II playoff of the WFTDA.
This one does appear to be a bit of a poser because we're up to the 3:30 mark. Obviously, we want to get all of these right.
Every little bit of it. And again, not to be presumptuous, but at the moment it does appear that St. Chux has a very good possibility of winning this game with a 66-point lead. Not completely insurmountable in 3 minutes and 15 seconds, but it would be a fairly epic comeback by Jet City if they could manage to do so.
Patricide actually coming out to speak with the box manager.
So, yeah, I mean, one of the things that was changed in the rules this year is that NSOs can issue penalties as well. So they're probably discussing some clarifications with the NSOs, and especially at the champion or at the playoff tournaments, you know, the top level NSOs are here, and therefore would not be surprised if the penalty box manager was empowered with such powers. All right, Patricide has news, and Trailer Trash is doing the worm on the side. He's pretty excited.
Jedi Nightingale joining him.
You, of course, can't see any of this on screen. Sorry about that, but it is very entertaining for us.
And our producer, Dill Hero, has gone off to the sideline to see if we can get some more detailed clarification.
Here we go.
After review, the high block penalty will stand. No additional penalty will be assessed for the action.
Okay. There you go.
So, no additional penalties coming in. We did have miscellaneous skaters and helmet covers coming to and from the penalty box. But you heard it here first from Patricide.
No penalty. So, let's get the last 3 minutes and 15 seconds of this game underway. Jedi Nightingale taking the start, but it's going to be Eva Derici getting lead jammer first. Jedi Nightingale out, hot on her tail. Three blockers versus two. Not going to be any points scored as Eva Derici not wanting to complete this race. We'll get another jam going.
So just under 3 minutes left on the period clock, Captain Lou. 189 for St. Chux, 123 for Jet City. Ivana Hercha coming to the Fast Girl start line for Jet City, number 5, has 22 points thus far.
And St. Chuck's keeping Jedi Nightingale out there. It's almost like they want her to get that 100 points. Jedi Nightingale bumped out of bounds by Assaulted Peanut, and back-to-back jams. Jet City able to get lead jammer over her. Ivana Hercha is lead jammer in this. Comes around on the scoring pass, bumps into Pixie Destruction, twirls around her, gets past her. Jedi Nightingale out of the pack as well. Jam's going to get called off. 4 points picked up by Jet City. Down by 62.
St. Chuck's going to send Psycho Kitty Freak out, number 14, to the Fast Girls start line. Number 39 is Whoa Nelly for Jet City. We have an almost empty DerbySupply.net penalty box.
Close to it.
Only one occupant. It's a standing one at that.
Whoa Nelly trying to work her way through the front of the pack. Gets an assist from Nasty Nikki Nightsticks on some offense. Is going to pick up lead jammer. Three lead jammers in a row for Jet City. It might be a little bit too little too late, but they are putting on the afterburners as this game draws near its conclusion. A minute and 20 seconds remain on the period clock. Psycho Kitty Freakout does get out of the pack, and the hands were attempted to go to the hips, but a back block was called before she could get them there. No whistles will be blown as Wonelli will go to the DerbySupply.net penalty box. And I suppose one whistle was blown, the whistle for her penalty that was called.
Indeed. So Psycho Kitty Freakout looking to bring this home for St. Chuck's on the power jam right now. Getting around Nasty Nikki Nightstick and Start a Riot. Last two defenders to beat up at the front. Puts up the 5-point pass.
She'll take those five and keep on going. 58 seconds left in the jam. We are on the jam clock. The period clock with 35 seconds left in it is less time than the jam clock. So we'll go to the conclusion of this jam and then we'll be done the game. Whoa Nelly out of the penalty box, re-engaging at the back of the pack, at the front of the pack in the two wall. Ill Ninja, Nasty Nikki Nightstick holding up Psycho Kitty Freakout. Psycho Kitty Freakout now with only one to beat. That one is Nasty Nikki Nightstick again. No penalties on her whiteboard, but also not able to stop Psycho Kitty Freakout that go around. 4 points snagged by Whoa Nelly getting through on her scoring pass. 5 seconds left in the period, 20 seconds left in the jam and game. Whoa Nelly bumped to the inside.
Psycho Kitty Freakout saw
she's
the clock
tired.
Hit zero. I really want to call that jam, and I'm going to show you what that looks like, but I'm going to keep going because there is still time on the jam clock, and I'm not lead.
There's only 5 seconds left, so she doesn't have to jam too much more in order to achieve the victory that she and her teammates will be delighted to have achieved. St. Chuck's Derby Chicks get past the double century mark. 206 look to be their final total. It is unofficial at the moment. We'll see if there's any mathematical changes before we declare it final. But with a 71-point lead over Jet City, I'm pretty safe in saying that St. Chuck's will advance to that 5-6 game tomorrow.
Which is indeed a rematch of the very first game here this weekend at the Division II in Cleveland, and facing off against Brandywine.
And you know that Brandywine game, Mr. Whistler, was a very close game with Brandywine in the lead for the majority of that game until right near the end. St. Chuck's was down by 18 points and put up a 28-point jam, which put them into a 10-point lead, which is exactly the amount that they won the game by. So St. Chuck's and Brandywine, I am really looking forward to that rematch for 5th and 6th place. Those are the 10 and the 7 teams that have come into this tournament, so both will improve their seeding. And Jet City, you know, Jet City, nothing to be too sad about in this game. They're going to be going into the 7-8 game, so they will at least hold their seeding, and they will meet up against the rivals that they played on Friday as well.
Yeah, Oklahoma Victory Dolls, who are improving their seeding, came in as the 9th seed. So they will finish no worse than 8th themselves. And this one is going in the books as a 206 to 135 victory for St. Chuck's. Coincidentally, 206 points what St. Chuck's scored yesterday morning when they defeated Brandywine, 206 to 196.
So very consistent scoring on the part of St. Chuck's. I think a really nice performance by Pack and Black. They did get 97 points out of Jedi Nightingale, but not even half the points this time around. I mean, it's good when they don't have to rely on her that much.
And that's kind of an interesting problem to have when she's having an off game on the stats sheet and still putting up 97 points.
That's right.
It's a good problem to have if that's the kind of problem you have to worry about.
So once again, St. Chuck's Derby Chicks winning this game, moving on to the number 5 bracket tomorrow. They will be playing at 4 o'clock for that chance to finish in 5th. And Jet City with 135 points, moving on to the 7-8 game, playing at noon tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
And that's about it for us.
Here at 8 o'clock Eastern time, which is going to be in about 22 minutes or so, we will see Houston taking on Kansas City. Winner of that game will go to the gold medal game tomorrow against Demolition City. And the other team will be taking on Santa Cruz at 4 tomorrow in the third place game.
That's right. So the gold ticket matchup is coming up next. Stay tuned to WFTDA, TDA.TV. Mr. Whistler, Captain Lou Obamo, hope you enjoyed the game. Stay tuned.